All right, so we're getting into the game plan. Got Reggie Theus. He's another 6'7" point guard. We already faced the Grizzlies before, but I think I forgot the game plan. I don't know. I delete it every time. Going under, you know, just in case injuries. So it wouldn't even matter. Digging in the post, because he's not, like, crazy in the post, but he's got a little bit of skill. Of course, he's old school. Tight. Off ball, going over the off ball screens for Kendall Gill. He's a pretty good shooter. Going tight for on ball for Pascal Siakam. Pre-rotating for Marc Gasol, doing a little dig as he does in, his thing in the post. Gonna do some matchups right now. Marc Gasol obviously is going to be guarded by Moses, so they can fight it over in the paint. Siakam's going to be with KG, and Penny Hardaway will be guarded by Jaylen Brown. And Reggie Theus, I'll take Reggie Theus because he's probably going to be coming off the bench. Monta Ellis might be in. I don't want Monta guarding Reggie. I'll do it. The 34-23, just won one game. Jim Jackson is out with a pulled lower back muscle. He's day-to-day. We played the Grizzlies with Jim Jackson healthy, so we're going to see what it's like with him injured and not in the lineup. I have no clue why I'm in the away right now. I'm just kind of like, yeah. But anyway, this is a home game, so we're going to choose the Cobra One serves. Let's get it.
If you're looking for a party this Saturday night, we're bringing you one. It's the NBA on 2K Sports. I'm Brian Anderson, along with Grant Hill and Clark Kellogg. Our reporter, Allie LaForce.
I mean, they had to be exhausted after that double overtime session. But in the end, they came away with the upset win.
And it's going to be the Grizzlies off the tip.
And check it out. We still at a B plus. That's fine.
Pascal Siakam out there with Joe Ingles.
Once we get that A-minus, I'm going crazy, though.
Gasol misses. Stolen by Siakam.
It's a way to start.
Fantastic athlete.
Siakam getting his two off.
Shows on the glass to keep plays going.
Penny Hardaway is guarding me. They got Joe Ingles. Joe Ingles starting at the three. Instead of Jim Jackson.
The board. On the break. Ingles passes to Hardaway. Lets it go from 11. And too long on the shot.
Phew. I'm glad he missed that. In transition, let's go. Do a little left. Do a little right. But it's not the same left, right. The my player guys who don't know how to play basketball. Alright, so.
Here's Gil.
Ooh. That was a good move. That was a good take. Got something for that ass.
Defensive performance.
Jump right on time, too.
That kind of rejection early on energizes your squad. The coaching staff just loves this kind of hustle.
And it's off him.
Johnson with it. And Grant, how often do players check
their
own stats?
JK. Going through the motions. Oh, yeah, there it is.
Some guys are just really
Glenn Rice got our first 3 points. You know how this game's going to go. Every time Glenn Rice gets it, you know. Solidified. Damn. I don't know. This one might be tough, though. Siakam hitting three. You would think because Jim Jackson is out that this would be a lot easier. But,
It's rebounded by Pascal Siakam.
KG ain't make the easy shot. Wasn't really so easy because I seen Hope coming. And you got Kendall Gill dunking the ball. Yeah. Not as easy as I thought it would be.
Back to Johnson. Over to the wing. Here's Rice. Fires in the triple.
Hey, Glenn Rice keeping us in the game. I love it. Second three of the first quarter. Let's go.
I mean, he'll be the centerpiece of their offense today. You can bank on that. Now here's Ingles.
Playing that defense in the corner. Marc Gasol's been tightly guarded by Moses, and I love it.
Now here's Johnson.
My man can play real true defense. It's really slight. It was really slight. I'm not going to lie. But that switch had to do it, or else he was going to block it. That wasn't going in. It might not even hit the rim or the backboard because it was pretty crowded up there. So I had to switch up the hand. Not necessarily switch hands, but switch my hand up as I'm doing the layup. Penny Hardaway hitting the open three. He'll hit a few if you let him. You don't prefer it, but if you let him, he'll do it. Another one of those, I use the icon, but I need a different pass, 2K. I need a different pass than that.
And that one goes in. Two from the line that time. First quarter of play, and just over 3.5 minutes in. Pass to Garnett. Shoots over Siakam.
I need a better shot, KG. Come on now. You're going through the motions. You gotta go through the motions too, man.
Here's Gill. Covered by Johnson.
KG on Penny.
Here's Gill. From the arc. That one won't fall. He's 1 for 3 on the day.
Good shot for us.
It's Johnson with a
let's go.
Two makes. Off to a good start.
That's what you call just getting in the space. You know what I'm saying? Getting that open space, getting that open space, and then lay it up in that open space. It's the right, it's the left. You know, right, left is used in real basketball, but not the type of right, left that people are used to. As far as, like I said, my player. Going left and right in a direction as far as just real dribble moves. A real thing. I mean, that's how
controlling the paint well, protecting the rim. That's exactly the kind of defensive effort.
It's all really about the shoulders.
Outside Johnson.
I wanted that three bad.
Pass to Rice. Here's Garnett. Defended
gave
by
it to Glenn. KG should have been doing something against Penny, but that's okay. Look at that. That looked like the Spurs offense. Straight passing to get an even better shot than what you had.
Beautiful. Teams have been thus far. Now here's Siakam. He has 7 to the middle. Here's Hardaway.
See, I was waiting for that. Willing to back down. I'm in the corner just waiting for it. Hands and it just hasn't stayed in those hands.
Hardaway's gotten 2 of his 3 shots to go tonight. Johnson against Hardaway. Fires it from 18. The shot by Johnson, no good.
He recovered a tiny bit. There was a little bit of help defense around, but I think that was a good shot. I don't know. I don't know how my teammates feel, but I feel like that was a good shot. Who knows?
It's hauled in by Garnett. Here's Johnson.
For 3. No. Man. Moses is not being the cleanup crew today. What happened?
Brown against Hardaway. They double him with Brown. Ingles from outside.
Oh, Ingles for 3.
First shot won't go.
Oh, can get it.
Johnson against Hardaway.
Got Penny guarding me. Funneled me right into Marc Gasol.
Pass to Gill. Back to Hardaway. Out to the wing.
At least we got the help defense. That's all I ask for. That's all I ask.
Williams finds Hardaway. 6 on the shot clock. Memphis needs to get off a shot.
Penny, no sir. Jaylen Brown getting in that. You know. Let's go. All right, so Ben Wallace is in the game. KG's still in there.
And here's Brown.
Jaylen Brown could have just turned around and shot it. He had to step in. Ben Wallace, cleanup crew, third member. Now that goes. Penny Hardaway trying his hand at a 3 again.
Hardaway's gone 2.
I think he's 1 for 3 this quarter.
Outside Johnson.
Here's Wallace. Brown inside, defended by Hardaway.
Jalen with the take.
And he recovers it.
Okay. Okay. Jalen with the hard take. They sub me out. Back in, we have momentum when they sub me out. So, of course, we're up when they sub me back in. Of course, we're up.
Johnson against Siakam.
Yeah, we're up by 10 now. Look at that.
Yeah, they really need to find a way to get back on track.
And for the Grizzlies, Joe Ingles is out there with Pascal.
I mean, that was a beautiful move. And there's Marc Gasol. He just couldn't get it because Moses Malone defense, you know. But it was still a good move.
Outside
Reggie
Johnson,
Diaz bodied me on the way to the rim. Got to do something else to get loose. They're doing a lot of good defense right now.
During the 12-13 season, Gasol still
playing things real tight. People are interchangeable. Rotations and shit.
And we're just over 2.5 minutes into the second.
It's a really tight team.
Oh, and there's the goal.
Thank God for the foul.
And he sinks the second. Here's Theus. Pass to Ingles.
Got the switch going. I don't mind Glenn Rice guarding Reggie Theus. Moses on Mark. Alright. Out of all the times I've seen Mark do his little thing at the post against Moses, that's like one for like four or five.
Here's Ellis.
Moses doing alright.
Inside. Five to shoot.
I have no alarm. I have no panic about it. Marc Gasol's not taking over the game, I can tell. Now, if someone else were to, i.e. a Penny Hardaway, that'd be different.
And there's the basket, and the whistle blows.
And Penny Hardaway light. Reggie Theus getting his three on. Not 3 points either. Or three-point shooters, or whatever, three-point shot. He's getting three to Hardaway. Let's put it that way.
Theus, a very efficient combo guard.
He's an old-school player. He'd rather get three to Hardaway than shoot the three.
And does it all at a high level.
Honest to God. Here we go. This is leading into something. He's leading into something. Get out my way.
Or maybe even a question mark.
And guys, I know there are a lot of questions right now defensively for this team. There's no doubt about that.
Yeah, baby,
Gasol's gone
looking
just
good.
Five from the floor.
What are you talking about? Going through the motions, Glenn Rice. I honestly thought he was about to shoot that. I mean, he is, but actually, that shot that he almost had, he should have just shot that instead of that one.
So it'll be two.
Please don't be me. Okay.
And good on the second, so he makes them both.
Man, I usually don't even get in foul trouble in the first quarter or the really the second quarter, the first half. But when I did against the Celtics, man, oh man, it was really like a handful of times that I really get in foul trouble. You know, we played over 50 games. Y'all can check yourselves. First half, usually don't have fouls.
So he hits both free throws.
So when I did against the Celtics, that shit was traumatizing. Not for me getting too many fouls, but when I came back in, fam, our asses were down 17 points. The moment I came back in.
Now here's Gasol.
Look at that defense, man. Moses Malone against Marc Gasol. Moses is winning this matchup.
Any kind of consistency.
And he's not even going crazy on offense. It's just straight. Moses is playing the best defense that you can on Marc Gasol. And Marc Gasol is not successful yet. He only made like one or two shots the whole time.
Pass to Rice. Here's Malone. Check by Gasol.
Hit him with the pick. Oh man, did I just leave Monta open like that? Did I hit him with the pick to where he's just wide open under the rim? Maybe so. I'm trying to get my pick game better, I'm not gonna lie. But it's so hard when you can't necessarily pick the direction they're facing when they, like, it's really hard to do that shit.
Offensive rebound.
Damn, I've done that shit so many times that I thought it was going in. I don't know why.
He's been ice cold tonight.
It was a good shot though. Nobody can tell me otherwise.
Really could have used this contribution.
Pass to Ellis.
One for seven is nuts. But hey, when you depend on Marc Gasol, and we have Moses Malone on the other side of him, that's what happens.
Here's Garnett. Ingles defending. Here's Ellis. And they recover it. It's good.
My man moved him out the way.
Here's Theus. He's got five. Let's the three fly. Rebounded by Johnson.
Spin move. Ah, man. This is where I end up getting fucked up. So trying to touch the D-pad to get rid of shit on the top. And press the wrong one. And I was just trying to get the shit off the screen, so I just had to pass the ball. I couldn't pay attention. I don't know. I don't think I like playing with the my player thing on top. Like seeing my stats and shit like that. I feel like it kind of motivates the wrong thing. I literally just scored 58 points this past week. Like literally a game ago. Or I guess two games ago if you count. Okay. But I wasn't looking up at the stats. Like just counting up the points or the rebounds. Like, oh, I'm two rebounds away from a triple double. I need to get them. Like, it kind of just messes with your head a little bit. Oh, here he goes making a three. It kind of messes with your head a little bit when you constantly just see the stats of like what you're doing. It's different when it's on the scoreboard, like as far as in the gym or gymnasium, arena or stadium. But as far as it being on the screen, like a score track or like a scoreboard, box screen, whatever you want to call it, nah, it just motivates the wrong thing for me, I guess. You know, I don't know about anyone else, but you know, it just happens to be my player, the place where people break ridiculous records doing the wildest stats, and it's like I feel like that's promoted more so because. I'm not saying promoted by 2K, I'm just saying it promotes people to do that more because they see their stats in the corner of the screen. So you always would want to fix the stats to how you want to, therefore you would do things on the court according to that. I'm so mad about the charging call. That's really a charging call. How many times have we seen people fall? Come on, dog.
Here's Hardaway.
Like a flail. He's bigger than me. He's 6'7", bigger than me. Whatever, bro. All I did was spin, like, all right. Anyway, yeah, I just don't like having stats up near me. You know, I'd rather score and do all these things, rebounds, assists, and then figure it out towards the end. Because I know I was kind of immersed in the game, one, you know, and then two, I mean, the stats are going to be the stats. So if you play good and do all the right decisions, or mostly all the right decisions, shit like that that you just seen right there, you might end up with 58 points and 10 assists. It wasn't planned on. I ain't planned on it, but at the same time, I was just playing through the game and basically trying to win to where I don't see the stats. I don't want to. Anyway, up by three, we was just up by 10 when I subbed in. So they got a little momentum going.
To the right side.
Doing the triple threat style. Oh yeah, I guess for those who don't know, or those who are curious about a few things. One, the settings that I play on. So you use the All-Star settings. Three, some of my signature stuff. Great dunk. First. I mean, I'm pretty sure some people know, but I guess you just have to tell for the people who may not know. Not talking about this one, talking about the next one I say. But this one I say, the signature size up is break for Alston, skip to my lose. And the combo size up is Kobe. Kobe's combo size up is a little bit more popular. They might.
Was before the buzzer, but it's off target. And the first half comes to an end. We've got a close game going here. They lead by 5.
Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. Taking a look at this home squad. Kenny, how'd you see it?
Love to see a team grind for those offensive boards. They're doing the dirty work and converting those extra possessions into points. It's got to be demoralizing for the defense at this stage.
Shaq, your take on Memphis.
Well, they've been getting worked on the glass. Out-muscled. Where's the fight? I know they got some tough matchups down low. But if they really want to win the game, they need to crash the boards way harder in the second half.
And that'll do it for our halftime report. Stay tuned for the second half. About to get underway.
As we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard. Here's Rice. Down to 5 on the shot clock. The 3 is up. Gasol grabs the board. Gasol's got rebound number 5 here tonight. And for Memphis...
Oh, man. Down by... up by 5. Penny shooting the 3. Yo, I thought Mark was going to make that rebound. I'm so glad Moses is just fighting with this man in the paint. Easy two. Perfect pick and roll play. To a perfection. Put a little defense on it. Such an easy shot is turned difficult. You can say the same for Glenn Rice just shooting that shot right there. But we're going to keep moving.
He's got 11. Pass to Gasol.
I was about to say, damn, Penny about to hit him with the slow box. Pause.
Gasol's got his second basket of the night.
Terrific
body control from Gasol there. Navigating the defender.
I feel like he's about to do something crazy for a second.
Here's Rice. Let's it go from deep. Here's Malone.
He shot it like it was going in.
Makes it with the kiss.
Moses knows. Clean up crew style.
Here's Malone. Ingles defending.
Mm.
To Brow.
Mmm. No extra pass this time. That's fine. I'll let him have it.
Now
by
Hardaway.
7.
Now Gasol. Covered by Johnson.
Gotta steal it.
Gasol inside. Johnson on him.
Like, I'm trying my hardest to block this shit outside, or fucking Brown. Have enough defense to contest it. No, sir. Moses Malone. Clean up crew.
Simply controlling the glass. I mean, plus 10.
Wow, quick.
Rebound right now.
Over time, we have seen Siakam blossom into a star.
Okay, so right now it's like a scoring fest here in the third quarter.
The Grizzlies pull it in.
Ooh.
Gasol's got 6
Gotta
rebounds.
Gotta miss.
It's really surprising that they're up at this
point. I thought Glenn Rice could pick him up.
Look at those moves.
So
the
Marcus Saul is struggling 1-for-7 with just great
excellent
right now,
work around the rim.
Left or 2-for-9, who knows.
And reaching for air.
But so is Glenn Rice. 1-for-10.
Ball's knocked loose.
It's terrible.
And Gasol with the block. And he's able to get it back. Wow, potent offense.
Moses can't do it.
Fun to watch.
Just aggressive and effective. Taking it right to the defense.
Come on, man. You left him way too open. Such a feat at the 3. That's like one of my favorite spots right there. The volleyball line. It's right above or right below the logo.
They are just owning the boards.
Right above the regulation 3-point line.
Really,
I don't know. It's like a good place to just kind of place yourself. Just right across that line in the middle of the court.
The Grizzlies pull it in.
All the way across in that box.
Pass to Hardaway.
Volleyball box.
Floats one up. Siakam with it.
I mean, he got his rebound. Shit. You just gotta get the points, Mark.
From a double-double. A terrific effort. He's made such a big
impact. Ooh.
Oh,
I mean, I'm glad the icons helped me out on that one as far as the pass. I would hate for that to get stolen because the pass was incorrect.
easy to him. It's quite easy when you get that
high. Okay, mid-range. It's usually where he's comfortable at.
Pass to Johnson.
Ooh, I could have done a turnaround. That would have been crazy. I had to give it to KG. I had to take it hard to the rack. What are you talking about? That's Penny Hardaway.
I mean, you have to love this approach. You want to get the ball to the
I ain't going up soft. Great defense. Better offense.
And it's out of bounds.
Wow, my man tried to steal it from me. This is crazy.
How about that strong defensive performance for this?
He ain't got hops, height,
Shoot,
he's out here.
An energy boost off a block like that one.
Williams has checked in for Gasol. Pass to Ellis.
Ooh. I mean, I don't mind it. Nice. Take it hard to the rack, bro. Clean up crew got you.
Kevin Garnett doing a nice
as long as
job
one of them is in. Usually that's the case.
To snag missed shots.
To the left side wing. To the inside.
Damn. Pop my ass, man.
To change it up.
Had to call a deal.
Fantastic ball movement for them tonight.
If things are definitely working offensively, a balanced attack is just so much harder to defend.
Hero, no good.
We could get a better shot than that. I feel. In the corner, Penny Hardaway still in the game.
And they get it back.
Obviously, after getting that rebound and put back.
Hardaway's got 13.
Oy, or a second chance point, whatever you want to call it.
As of late, and he's been magnificent tonight. I wasn't quite sure if he'd be able to maintain that same level of play. I had my doubts coming into this game.
It's too far in for the volleyball line. And somebody else is recovering, so I ain't wanna, you know.
Pass to Ellis.
Then again, that wasn't much of a shot. And you turned it over. Come on, Monty. And you let him score. Come on, bro.
15 points in the game.
If they keep we up by four. I'm still using the same right now. I don't know why. We have like eight losses total. That somehow I'm my first option. But anyway, we're up by four. Hit the free throw shot. Come on, man. That's a free throw. Literally.
He has a skill set to get consistent points and knows how to find his spots on the floor.
Washington outside.
It's kind of sickening. I've seen a picture of the NBA shot chart in real life.
Pass to Wallace.
And analytics has ruined the game. But I want to put a picture of my shot chart because I actually haven't seen it. I have not checked my shot chart. I haven't had a reason to do it. I don't know where the fuck like most of my shots are even coming from on the court. I really don't know. But since this is the end of the week, I do have videos other than this league coming out and, you know, other things too. So, yeah, just watch out. Watch out for things. Reggie Theus, mid-range. Had to call a T.O.
Game here in Philadelphia. Pass to Johnson. Here's Garnett inside. And so he draws back. He's perfect from the line this time.
He's as solid as it gets from the line. I mean, give him the opportunity.
This shit is crazy because I just ended up, I was editing. And I was watching one of the games while I was editing. And it ended up being the Roots versus Blizzard.
You can't say that with enough emphasis.
And I basically stopped what I was doing just to watch like the last minute, 2 minutes of it. That shit was crazy. It's on the YouTube channel. Go ahead and check it out. Yeah. Set your feet, hit the three. We up.
Williams passes to Oubre.
Kelly Oubre trying to back down Tyler.
Shoots over Hero.
It's not happening.
Oubre can't hit.
You know, he tried his hand.
From behind the arc. And the rebound goes to the
I thought that was going in. I'm not going to lie.
Williams has got his sixth rebound on the night.
He's lost his rhythm completely this quarter.
Monta is having a great game.
Throws it up high. Nice catch.
11 points off the bench.
Nice good for him. Both ends of that alley-oop. Hey, when he let
shooting
go of
around
pass,
50%.
I had no idea what he was going for.
Neither did the defense.
Thank you, man. Finally, they using my pickoff. Their own will.
Yep, that one's good. 4 points in the quarter. Plays like that.
My man went straight to the rack.
Easy for him. Hardaway with it. He's got 15. Ingles, he's checked in for Memphis.
Man, what is going on?
Not afraid to put his body
subbed out, subbed back in. Not much of a rest. I think it was like maybe 30 seconds at the most. I don't know, maybe the coach had to tell me something before I got back in. Who knows? Who knows? All I do know is we need to hit this buzzer beater just because I've been hitting a lot of buzzer beaters lately. Like a lot. Ah! Got to do something. Ah, no. I can't do nothing with that.
Over Ingles. And the shot falls short that time. Here's Theus.
Damn.
Hit there. And that'll do it for the third quarter. They lead by 7. And we're just moments away from the start of quarter number 4. Stay with us. And now a sneak peek into the huddle with Scott Brooks.
Every time we contest, every time they make it, don't get frustrated. Just reboot the computer, defend again, every time. Just keep defending. They're going to make tough shots. Great players.
Maintaining that positive attitude.
To keep his team spirits up. All right, fourth quarter. Sometimes
great defense gets beat by better offense.
It's time to get it popping.
Fourth quarter has arrived. So good to have you with us.
He's trying to find his shot, but at some point you have to start making these.
And hey, he gets one a game. He gets one a game.
It's Gill in at the 2,
attacking the rim with power.
Tremendous finish.
Really piling on the lead.
Ingles, good.
I'm really curious about the shot chart.
Lays it in, coming off that pick.
Johnson with it, guarded now by Williams.
Oh, it's going in. Damn it.
Oh, and that one, no. What just powered it down.
Yeah, I would love to see my shot chart and see, like, not necessarily where I score from, but
it is certainly making an impact
the
tonight.
Amount of shots
well, you know,
in each
take
space
care of the
on the court.
Defensive glass, it's
because,
be hard to
like I said, I don't have the stats constantly on the top like it's my player. I just kind of try to play
Ingles
within the rhythm. At the same time, like the Celtics game, we were down 20 points basically for three whole quarters. Well,
the Grizzlies with some
a half, and then the third quarter we were down by double digits the whole quarter. So, you know, a couple of these 50-point games, how does that correlate to the shot chart that I'm going
to
have?
But
like I said, I have videos coming out.
Maybe the biggest reason
so
he can drive the ball
you could just
create the space he needs
or it could be
jumper,
a short
and he's no longer
either way
turnover waiting to happen.
I kind of want to show my shot chart compared
nice
to
deep.
The current
Here's
NBA
the
shot chart and it could be a lot different. I do
Outside
know
Brown.
NBA players
Here's
do
Malone.
Wow, I almost got that stolen. Still didn't make it though. I do know NBA players do shoot mid-range shots, but just having an average just seems like it doesn't, or they don't. So, yeah, basically what I'm going to be looking at is the difference between their mid-range and my mid-range, and how many spaces in mid-range do I shoot from, and how often I do it, and how often I make it, obviously, but yeah. Very interesting shit, man.
Here's Theus, covered by Johnson. Here's Gill. 6 to shoot for 3.
Mark for 3. Trying to change things.
Outside
as far as
Johnson.
The outcome of the game.
Brown with it.
Oh, yeah. I love that take. Not take to the rack, but like just. From 3-point range. I don't know. I love that shot, I guess.
Saw a weakness in the perimeter defense.
Good shit.
And took advantage of. He really hasn't had it all.
Shit, cleanup crew.
This team needs him to
definitely got to have Moses at the 5 and Ben Wallace is in. Ben Wallace isn't necessarily going to be getting the ball thrown to him in the post like that right there. Like you just seen. Definitely not going to get the double team to get towards you. Like, oh, it was really just a dig. It wasn't a double team, but. It's almost the same thing when you have to leave your man open, and Jaylen Brown, he's going to hit it. Not every time, of course, but you leave him open enough, he's going to hit one.
Beyond the arc, Bryce's shot is off. Going into halftime, he had 2 threes in his pocket, but hasn't added to that total since.
Ben Rice is struggling now.
Here's Theus, covered by Johnson.
I tried my hardest to get like the apex, the release of the layup. Nothing. Nada. Zilch.
Outside Johnson.
Oh man, I hit niggas with that. That's an interesting move that I'm doing lately. I hit them with it in clutch time against the Jordan team.
Here's Brown.
Yeah. And it's like a side step with the right hand if you're already on the right side. Like, you kind of just. Ah, man, it's so hard to, like. Navigate and try to figure out how that happens in real time to kind of keep it smooth. I did it, and then I'm talking about when I was playing the jump man. I did it, and then I did an in and out with my right hand. And he reached with his left. And then I faced up against Horace Grant and stealth defense, I think. And fucked around, did a 360 layup on him.
So, yeah. And again, Memphis no good. Outside, Brown. The three ball. The shot misses.
Oh, man.
It's Memphis the other way. Just hasn't found much consistency.
Oh, man. He's not shooting that three, buddy. I know you wanted it.
Here's Ingles.
Kind of wanted that steal. Wow, he really got past Jaylen Brown like that.
Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with Allie.
Call it Theo.
Guys, thanks a lot. I had a chance to hear what Mike Malone was saying to his team. He loves the pressure deep. He told his guys, quote, "We've got them on their heels. They're making mistakes."
So that right there is the Kobe signature, just in case
anyone's wondering. We'll see if they can maintain their disruptive ways down the stretch. Back to you.
I guess what I'm messing for is I've been hearing a little bit about the Kobe signature, combo signature, you know, between the legs. And I really like that signature, to be honest with you. Just because you can really take it anywhere. You can take it left and right, and it's kind of just there for you. I don't know how he just missed that. He missed a whole ass layup. I don't think he's used to me throwing layups to him. Like, when's the last time I threw a layup to Glenn Rice, bro? If that was KG, different.
Bro.
I don't know. Glenn Rice. At the same time, you be trying to post that. You might dunk on a fast break.
They struggle, but hey, you cannot.
We think we're all-time people that don't know how to catch a lead.
He's getting it done. Knocks it loose. And
I mean, even that right there, like, he got my back on that one. Yeah.
Pass to Johnson. The three.
4-3, set your feet, hit the three. All right, I'm with another one, center.
And here's Brown for
oh,
three.
Shit, you really tried hitting one of them. Jaylen Brown was not making that. Sorry to say. I wanted to cross over to the right, but I'm starting to look at my health. I'm going to need that. I'm going to need that for something.
Here's Malone. Give him that one. Now shooting
five.
Now let's present our New Balance Player of the Game.
This has been one of the most dominant performances I've ever seen. What's incredible is he has no off switch, just a tremendous motor, and he's making an impact on every single possession. And look at him. You think it's just another game. He is totally in control of his emotions.
Hey, these fans love him so much, and when he gets it going, they respond. The crowd fueled his performance.
Yes, sir. And we back, and we back.
And here are the Grizzlies now. Down by 15.
Player of the game right here. Can't deny it.
Here's Gasol. And a foul. All right. NBA champions. How about that?
Tight defense, I understand.
Johnson passes to Brown.
Man, I hit the Hawks with that same move, and that shit worked.
Six on
it was
the shot clock.
Powell, not Penny Hardaway.
Off target from outside.
Yeah, you know, he usually makes you pay from that range.
Pass to Gil.
Okay, what we doing?
Launches a three.
Oh my God.
On target.
Honestly, didn't expect him to shoot that. So call the T.O.
So it's the home team now.
And I didn't even call the T.O. soon enough. Oh yeah, I did. I called it right before 3 minutes. 2 minutes.
Here's Rice. He's
gonna just take away a timeout anyway.
Shot clock at six.
I kind of wanted to give it to Glenn Rice, but Kevin Garnett was a good suffice. As long as they're both open hitting that shot, didn't really matter. Ooh, post play is alive. Oh, I wasn't even the highest scoring person in the game last game. The highest scorer on our team was Moses Moore last game.
Grabs the board.
You know, he's just
and probably
it up
the
from
highest
distance this quarter. If you're going to do this, especially in the second half, you better make them.
And KG led the league in rebounding one time.
11 feet
maybe
out.
A couple times.
No good. Off the front rim. A minute 58 left to play in the fourth quarter.
All right, KG, I'm going to need you to do
pass
some.
To Rice. Takes the three. Drops in the three.
Dang, Rice is pulling up.
In the final period. We'll
oh, now he want to make the shot.
You know what? Teams can get a little three happy down the stretch sometimes. Letting it fly.
To the inside. Brown with the steal.
Told us he was struggling.
Here's Johnson. Gasol grabs
damn,
the
damn, I wanted that.
Gasol's.
I wanted that fast break so bad.
Back to Hardaway.
I was willing to adjust my shot against Marcus Gasol one more game.
Brown with the block.
Oh, man. Being within single digits is crazy. That right there was the Ray Crosby signature.
Fires the three.
People ask about.
Offensive board. Outside. Brown. Stolen by Ingles.
Man, I think I was trying to go somewhere with it, but the moment he didn't fall for the fake spin, fake 180 half spin,
and he
kind of threw me off.
And that brings him within 10.
In their position, they really need to cash in on every chance at the line.
Down by 10.
Rice. This one for three. Gets the three ball to go.
Just continue to attack, even late in the game, while they're up big. I don't think you want to get loose and sloppy or ease up, but it is time for them to start using that
you
clock.
Can't make the shot. I think, ladies and gentlemen, we can call it a game. Somebody call a little flip. Look, flip, flip. Game over.
And a great assist by Brown. Up top, Johnson. Up and over Hardaway. It's off. And so they get the victory here at home. A clean win, and one where they clearly showed better energy.
Yeah, so true. They put on a show here at home. And I really think they had that extra swagger and confidence, too.
And that'll do it, folks. For Allie LaForce, Clark Kellogg, and Grant Hill, this is Brian Anderson thanking the NBA presented by 2K Sports. So long, everybody.
Yeah, we definitely held our own this game. Almost had a triple-double, one or two, two rebounds away, one assist away. Almost had 30 points. Everyone was in double digits, as you can see.